Welcome to Spine Educational Channel. In this video, we will animate fire in Spine using real footage with chroma key. We will download the footage, clean up its background and polish it in Photoshop. And finally, animate it in Spine. I made a video explaining when and how to animate VFX in Spine. Check it out if you have missed it. We also have a playlist that covers a lot about VFX in Spine. I'm Arman, I animate characters for games using Spine2D software, sharing with you my recent works that include tons of VFX animations. Enjoy! If you like what you see, make sure to follow me on Twitter, where I post my works every week. And to support this channel, like the video or share it with your colleagues. Now, let's assume we are doing slots scene, where realistic fire should appear on the bottom. You can do it in After Effects, but that will generate long sequences which will result in a huge sprite sheet. While in Spine, we can avoid that by taking small pieces of that footage and looping inside Spine. We can then duplicate it to create a rich variety and break the repetitiveness. You might ask, why not to do the same duplication and looping in After Effects? What is the difference? Well, Spine reuses the initial sequence, no matter how many times you duplicate or modify it, while After Effects eventually will render for you the whole scene frame by frame. We don't need that, right? Now, let me find some footage that suits for us. After surfing for 15 minutes, I found this one. Clean it up wherever you wish, as long as you remove the green screen and maybe do some color correction. I use Photoshop. Let's do that now. Open Photoshop. Go File, Import, Video Frames to Layers, select the footage. Here you can either import it fully or just a portion of it. Depends what you found. I will go with the range. The moment you touch these sliders, the second option will be picked automatically. Let's pick a nice loopable section. Would be great if the range also contains something interesting, but not too noticeable, to avoid repetition. Note that you also can skip frames when importing with this option. Let's go without that for now. Nice, we have our layers. Add background at the bottom level to see how fire will look in the game. Next, create an action for the cleanup and polishing, so you can apply it onto rest of the layers. I won't be explaining how I do the cleanup, since there might be a much better way to do that. However, I won't speed up so you can at least see me doing it. action is ready. Next, just run it for the remaining layers. Our sequence is ready. Enable all layers and trim the document. Use Spline script to export the layers. Open Spline, create a new project and save it where you exported the sequence. Drag the first image and convert it to mesh. Rest of the frames we will import as linked meshes, so they can inherit mesh structure from the source mesh. This one. Less meshes, better. We can leave source mesh as is and jump right to the bringing the other frames. For that, make sure source mesh is selected. Open new option and click on linked mesh. After that, just duplicate it until you reach the maximum count of the sequence, which is in my case 44. Maybe I will reduce it later. For now, let's leave it. Select all the frames and clear the path, so they can load their images using their names as paths. Change to animation mode and key the frames, so we can finally see initial animation. Before composing Fire by duplicating it and modifying, we need to make sure that we have a nice loop. Right now, it is not looping, since we've just cut it from long footage. We can do it by overlapping two fire effects one on the other, by fading out the first one and fading in the second one. Let's try it. But first, import background so we can see how it may look in the game. Resize it. Create a simple fade in and fade out on the fire slot. Duplicate the slot. Now we need to fully show the second slot when the first one starts to fade out. Similarly, second slot should be hidden only after first one is fully shown. Nothing changed, you may say. Indeed, we miss one last step, which is very important, since it can be confusing. We need to make sure the transitional part when the second slot appears, frames are continuous, so we just offset the timeline to where the second slot starts to appear. Copy 8 frames after the 44th frame and paste it at the beginning, so we can go back and remove whatever remains after 44th frame. We are done with the loopable fire piece. Now we can duplicate this set, resize them and position however we wish. Maybe you want to change blending mode and offset few pieces. Very good. And since we have prepared fire using linked mesh, we can add more details to the mesh, and we can modify any of the frames, and the whole sequence will inherit that change. That way, we can deform it to achieve more natural chaotic look of the scene. Here are some variations that I have done, leaving them in the project so I can share it with you in the description. Remember, all these still will use same initial image sequence. Want to see more VFX examples from my portfolio? Go check out this video. Thank you for watching, and let's welcome our new channel supporter, Olga Wilson. Guys, it's thanks to our supporters that I still believe in this channel. And yes, subscribe to participate in the next poll, where we will pick new idea for VFX.